Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for coming to my send-off despite the traffic and the rains. Maraming salamat. Kanina pinulungan ako ni Bea from Binibini. Sabi niya, para daw akong magde-debut. And yun yung feeling ko ngayon. Sakto hindi ako nag-debut. So, allow me to have this moment. And my sisters and my mom said kanina na to have fun. So that's making me think about, I'm thinking again, it's making me think about, am I taking things too seriously? Because that's what everyone has been telling me to do. And rest assured, your message is well received. I promise for you guys, I'll have fun in Japan next week. And to be honest, the past few weeks or months of preparation have been so hard. They've been so difficult. It's been unlike anything I've ever experienced. But every time I feel tired or when I'm tempted to cut corners, I think that I'm not doing this just for myself. I'm doing this for my country. I'm doing this for 100 million Filipinos who love pageantry. So I owe it to them, and I owe it to you guys, and I owe it to my country do everything I possibly can to win this. And let me tell you guys, that's the best motivator ever, to know that you're representing your country in the international stage. And people always ask me, are you nervous? Yeah, I'm nervous. But more than anything, I'm so excited. I'm so excited to show you guys, what we've been preparing for. I'm so excited to go to Japan and show you what I can do and the hard work that we've all done. And I say we because it's not just me. It's so many people helping me, like my mom said. It really takes a village to build a queen. And when I used to see that on Instagram, my past queens, I would think, parang, okay. But now I'm living it and we're really nothing without the people helping us. So I'd like to thank those people, first and foremost, Binibini Filipinas. Thank you so much, Sir Jimenez, Tita Liliana, Ms. Annie, Ms. Aina, Carl, Ate Jen. Never nila kami pinabayaan, and we feel so loved, it's a family. And of course, to my sisters, you guys are so sweet. Like I said, I'll follow your advice, and I think I grew as a person just by being with you guys. Iba yung experience ng pageantry, pero iba rin yung bonding natin after, and I got so much from that. Thank you so much, guys. And to my aces and queens family, and to all my mentors, to all my trainers, sobrang dami, to all the stylists, designers, makeup, hair and makeup artists, my coach is here. Maraming maraming salamat. I know na you're giving your time, your effort, just for my sake and for the sake of the country. So maraming salamat. Your effort does not go unnoticed. And also, lastly, to my family, my friends, and my loved ones who have supported me. Ian is here, Oyel, Maui Klein, and Dom. They've literally been with me since the beginning. I was with the four of them picking my screening dress when I didn't want to stand out. I didn't want to wear my bright orange dress because I didn't want to stand out. And they convinced me that this is Binibini Filipinas, this is your destiny, you need to stand out. So I wore the dress, it was a success, and I'll never forget that. And until now, they're still with me, they still message me, oh, kumusta ka na? Are you ready? Malapit na. We're just here for you. So I really appreciate it. More than my friends in pageantry, they're also like one of my closest friends. They've come to be my closest friends. Also to my stylist, Keith isn't here, but Jekko is here. They've helped me out so much. They made my life so easy. And I'm excited to show you our looks next week. So abangan niyo yun. And of course, to my mom and my dad. My brothers aren't here, nag-aaral sila, they're in sila school. But my mom, I think, nag-leave sa work to be here, thank you. and my dad, may hearing siya sa Cebu, pero ano yung nangyari, nasa niya ata sa ibang mga mukha. So, salamat, maraming salamat. If there's anything I learned from this experience, from pageantry, or my takeaway is that sobrang mahal na ko ng pamilya ko. Lahat ginagawa nila para sa akin, full support, anything that I need, not just my parents, but even like my extended family or my friends. They don't know anything about pageantry. They don't know what I'm going through. Pero full support pa rin sila, kahit anong kailangan ko, ibibigay nila para matulungan ako. So, maraming salamat. And so yun po, next week, aalis na ako. October 25, next Friday, is my flight to Japan. Please pray for me. I'm so excited. Like I said, I'll give everything I have to secure another crown for the Philippines. Maraming salamat po.
Alright, wow! Thank you very much. And it's true. Now that it takes more than a village, it actually takes an entire country and the support of a loving family to come up with a beauty queen just like a burning patch. Alright, now you guys know the drill. Alright, I know exactly who will ask the first question. So please state your name and the publication you represent. Go ahead, Paul.
Hi, Adam.
Adam from Sash Factor. Adam, I want to ask. Adam, actually, hi, Sash. Good afternoon. This is Adam Hinato from Sash Factor Pageant Site. I would just like to ask, you seem to be made of sterner stuff, considering that you're just a newbie in the pageantry world. Now, I'm curious to ask, which is harder to undergo? Training for Binibining Pilipinas or for your international pageant?
That's a tough question because I haven't reflected on it, but I would really have to say maybe Binibining Pilipinas, just because it's uncharted territory for me. I came into it not knowing anything. I felt like a headless chicken running around. But thank you to my mentors and my friends who helped me out. I think now in Miss International, it's a different arena. It's iba yung atake sa preparation. But I guess now I can say that I'm a pageant person, that I know a little bit about pageantry and I'm growing from experience. And I've learned something throughout those 3 months of Binibining Pilipinas, and I'm more confident now what I need to do. So it's still tough, but now I come into it more confident.
Thank you very much, and good
I guess I don't think na meron kami masyadong pagkakaiba. Pareho kami nangarap ng dalawang bagay na maging beauty queen at maging abogado. And napaka-proud ko na tinutuloy ko yun para ipakita sa mga tao na kaya namin, kaya ng isang babae, kahit anong gusto niya, hindi lang isang bagay. Kaya niyang pumunta sa dalawang magkaibang fields, statutory and law. And kung ano yung naipakita nila, ay sana ang goal ko, mas lalo ko pang ma-inspire yung mga tao, lalo na yung kabataan, na mag-aral, and kung gusto nila, abutin nila yung mga pangarap nila magulang ng Pilipinas.
Hi, Pat.
Hi, hello,
Pat. Hi. Well, Japan is a very beautiful country, and this international is one of the best pageants to be in. What is something that you're most excited to do when you get there?
What I'm most excited about is actually meeting everyone from all the countries. I don't think people have that experience ever to be immersed in a situation where there's so many people with so many stories. For example, countries like Albania or where Laren is. I don't think I will ever get to go to Albania, but to meet someone there and to possibly share stories, to see what their culture is like. I mean, I love learning about different people, and even if I don't go there, I'm carrying a piece of that with me. And so, doon ako pinaka-excited. In Binibining Pilipinas, of course, I got to experience that in different parts of the Philippines. That's also a very fulfilling experience for me na nalalaban ko na, oh, may ganito pa ng lugar doon. And I know that if I go there, I have a friend there.
Thank you.
Hi, Pasha. Good afternoon. Robert from Manila, Philippines. Two questions. Number one, what would you choose? Miss International Thailand for the Supreme Court Justice of the Philippines.
Miss International title ko. Hindi ko po naging pangarap maging justice. Let's leave it to them. I admire them, pero I see myself in other fields. So, baka may ibang tao, baka sino ni Carlos, kasi maging chief justice. But for
and last question, Corona or Pag-ibig? Corona, Crown or Love?
Corona.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Definitely a long match, Erika Concepcion of Manila Center.
I'm Erika.
You've achieved a lot as a young lady, and I salute you for that. My question, someday, what would you like to be remembered?
First of all, thank you so much for your time here. It's so nice. Maraming salamat. I'd like to be remembered, of course, as the person who brought the 7th Miss International crown to the Philippines.
Hi, Patch. Armin Atina, 24, Philippine Daily Inquirer. First of all, may I ask for your message to the Japanese people who are reeling after the devastation brought about by Typhoon Hagibis?
My message is, my heart goes out to you. I know the experience, because our country is also prone to floods, and year in, year out, we experience the same thing. And I want to say, I admire the Japanese people. They have excellent disaster response programs and systems, and they're one of the countries who are best prepared to deal with such calamities. So every year, they're faced with earthquakes and typhoons, and it's devastating, yeah, but it's very inspiring to me, to a Filipino, to see them after a week or within the month, their life goes on, and that's my dream also for the Philippines. I hope that when I get there, the mood has lifted a little bit, and that they're in my prayers.
Thank you. Hi, Bash. Good afternoon. My name is Jade. I'm here. My name is Jade, correspondent from Pageant Talk. I have a question. One of the advocacy of Miss International is about understanding, cultural understanding. What Filipino culture would you like to share, and why did you choose that culture?
My absolute favorite Filipino thing that we have is, of course, being family-oriented. Growing up Filipina, it's so normal to me to be close with your family, or like when you're already old, you still hang out with your family. So when I talk to other cultures, lalo na yung Western cultures, I'm surprised. And I want to share that with them, because I think it's kulang yung buhay mo pag wala yung pamilya mo. So hopefully I can bring that. And then to Japan, they're also very family-oriented, so I think that's a good commonality and or a bonding moment.
Another last one question. How do you connect your advocacy to Miss International goals and themes?
So Miss International now is actually campaigning for the Purple Ribbon campaign. It's against violence against women and children. And so my advocacy as a lawyer deals with social justice, and I want to, like I said, speak out for the marginalized and the oppressed sectors of communities, and precisely included in there are the women and the children. They're oppressed, they're a minority, and I've had experience dealing with that, dealing with cases. It's called cases for the anti-Gauzy law. We have that against women and children. So I know I have experience in advocating for those sectors, so I'm excited that I have a platform in Miss International, and the whole organization is supporting that. Thank you.
Hello, Patch. My name is Kim from the Daily Tribune. So, do you find any similarity about being a lawyer and being a beauty queen?
Wala, joke. Well, the first thing that comes to mind is hard work. Hard work talaga. As with anything, as with any endeavor in your life, you're never going to excel in it, you're never going to be an expert in it. You don't put in the hard work. So the formula I used to get through law school to become a lawyer, it's so different from becoming a beauty queen. The common denominator is hard work talaga and sacrifice. And if you have that mindset, I feel like I was trained to have that mindset to not give up, to put in my whole heart and my whole soul and my body to it, then you can succeed.
Thank you.
Hi, Pat.
Hello.
I hope that you would be able to use your crown further, even after Miss International, for your advocacy. My question is, what was the biggest transformation that you've undergone throughout this journey? I've seen you from day one. Sa loob mo, ano yung pinakamalaking pagbabago? In terms of attitude,
Hi, Tito Mario. Who's that? I know the answer to that. Like
yes.
I carry that every day, and it's self-confidence talaga. Alam ko nila, iyan nila o yel, wala akong confidence sa sarili ko. I didn't want to join kasi sino ba ako? Maganda, di naman ako maganda. I'll leave it to them, and nung press presentation namin, hinihinig yung legs ko, hindi ko mahihimatay ako. Ganun ako ka hilaw, ganun ako ka not confident about myself.
Hindi ka matago, Pash. Hindi ka nagsida.
Ako po, nakita ko. Pero, so yun po talaga, massive transformation, like Azini said, from day one, around April, May, March, so now I feel so secure in myself. I feel like I can do anything, and I encourage women to, you know, take the leap. Kahit nahihiya ka, kahit anong bagay yun, kahit takot ka, try mo pa rin kasi you only have room to grow. From where you are, if you do that thing, you're only gonna improve. And I'm a testament to that. And kung nakita niyo ako before, sobrang layo ko sa pagiging beauty queen, so dyan ka lang ako. And tinan niyo ako ngayon. So, you know, anything's possible. And kailangan mo lang to believe in yourself na kaya mo.
Thank you, Attorney.
Hello, Patch.
Hello,
I'm Jim Pakao for Marayo Business Insight. Yes, my question for you is, Miss International is one of the most traditional pageants in terms of presentation, and that includes the speech that you have to present when you make this appointment. So, can you give us a hint on what your advocacy or whatever you want, you'll be tackling in that speech?
Abangan na lang po natin, pero for sure it's gonna be about the advocacies and the themes of Miss International and also who I am as a person. I don't want to speak about something that I don't know and I don't mean. I use the same approach in Pilipini, Pilipinas. I answered Angelina Jolie kasi siya talaga yung idol ko. So I want to bring that attitude to the Miss International stage. I'm gonna say my speech from the heart, from my experience, from what I know and what's really important to me. So yun.
Hello guys. Okay, two questions. First question.
So, cheer all women, so simple, just practice kindness, respect, understanding, compassion, common sense, and to empower other people around you. Because through empowering others, you feel like you also empower yourself.
The last question is, and it's not a secret action.
Lahat ng support, lahat ng like, lahat ng share, lahat ng follow, lahat ng comment, lahat ng hot picks, you know, sobrang nag-contribute yung sa journey ko. And they say na di naman included ang fan base sa criteria, pero nakikita yun sa girl. It's through their supporters that they shine the most. And kaya yun, sobrang thankful ako sa mga lahat ng nag-support sa akin. And I hope you can still continue supporting me and praying for me until
this
international
event. All right, one last question before we move on to the next part. Please go ahead.
Hi, Bash. This is Archie from this side.
Hello.
Yung pagiging lawyer mo ba added pressure, or if there's any pressure at all for your personal family on November 12th?
Even in Binibining Pilipinas, being a lawyer was kind of an advantage and a disadvantage for me. An advantage, of course, because it helped me stand out, it helped people to have this, you know, like the people respect lawyers, so that's an advantage for me. But at the same time, there was so much expectation for me, especially for public speaking and Q&A. They put me in a different level. They expect me to be kind of a loser. To throw out these big words. So, I guess it's the same for Miss International, but I think I can prove to them naman that I deserve the title and that I'm gonna work to that advantage na lang. And I think that the Japanese, they respect naman professions such as law. So sana that makes me stand out, but I know that that's not everything kasi hindi naman requirement yung maging abogado sa Miss International. So I'm still gonna work hard in other sectors. I'm still gonna prove to them that I deserve this title.
All right, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Our friends on the media, maraming salamat sa inyong mga katanungan. All right, let us all wish Patch good luck as she makes the Philippines proud in the upcoming Miss International 2019 pageant. Atimbo! From University Patch ng Pilipinas. We are so proud. Okay. Alright, now it's time to move on to our next, what we will do. We will group your interviews. Alright? But before we do that,
allow me to thank everybody, and of course, in behalf of the Pilipinas Charities, our executive committee members, Direct Raymond Villanueva, who is here. Thank you very much in behalf of Mrs. Cochinita Bernardo, Mrs. Betsy Westendorf-Brias, and of course, our chair, Mrs. Stella Marquez Araneta. Thank you very, very much, everybody, for coming to our send-off. All right? We have grouped our interviews for batch. First, a TV crew. Second, the print media. And third, online media. And fourth, the blogger. So please note that follow-ups will happen after the interviews. Our peer group, lagod kayo kay Ma'am Annie, kayo ha? Our peer group has given you stubs.